Good afternoon, everyone. You know why I was so nervous? Because of today's guest special ministry. Today, JSBTC and LDC invite Reverend Fumito Izui from Japan. He was born in 1967 in Japan. And now he's working. He has been working at Nishi Hongwanji Temple since 1989 years, for around 30 years. And today he is teaching. He's teaching ritual and how to chanting to Jodo Shinshu young ministers at Gongshiji Chidosho, that belongs to Nishi Hongwanji Temple. And I was a student, his student, 2 years ago. At that time, yesterday I talked about that. So I was so afraid. But you know, he's a very gentleman and very kindness person. And Grand Sensei called him, please come to JSBTC, Canadian Jordan. And he said, yes, sure. And thank you very much, this is amazing. And a couple minutes ago, we went to Niagara Falls. We enjoyed it. Of course, I was his driver. But you know, I didn't feel nervous at that time because he also knows I'm working here as a minister, and he also respects my position or you know my job. So I had a very great time. Exactly great time. And I'm sure you will have a very special great time today. He will teach you how to chanting and why chanting is very important. He will teach you. So please listen carefully.
この度は京都の西本願寺から伊豆文人先生に、ご足労をお願いし、ここトロント仏教会に、お越しいただきました。伊豆先生は西本願寺で1989年からお勤めになり、今では恩式指導所という法令寺に、法要寺における作法や読経といった儀礼空間を重んじる僧侶育成機関で主任としてお勤めになられております。私事ですが、1年半前まで伊豆先生のもとで温かくも厳しいご指導を、いただきました。で、こうして本日も皆さんと一緒に伊豆先生の、ご指導をまたご教授をいただける、しかもここカナダでいただける、大変ありがたいご縁に合わせていただいたなと、この4日間大変楽しく、僕自身も楽しく研修を受けさせていただきました。で、今日はまた、トロント仏教会のご門徒さんとともにその、儀礼空間について学べる機会、大変楽しみにさせてもらっております。どうぞ一緒に、なんていうのかな、大事に一言一言大事に、皆さんと一緒に聴聞できたらと思います。それでは伊豆先生、よろしくお願いいたします。 And Reverend Grant translate in English.
I'd like to also just say, introduce Izui Sensei. For the members from Toronto, does he look familiar to you? Yes. This is actually his second visit here to Toronto. He was here in 2005 as part of when we had the grand opening. He was one of the four ministers that was playing the garaku. Is Aisha not here? Well, there was a girl here that earlier that played part of that garaku. Izui Sensei. 2005년에 나왔어요. 그런데 皆さん 改めまして, こんにちは。
So there are some people here who were also here for yesterday's lecture, and you might be thinking, oh, he's repeating himself, but for those who are here for the first time, he'd like to start off with some of the basic rituals that as members of the Jodoshi we should all know.
So for all of you, you probably are used to it, but the starting at the very, very basic, whenever we enter a hondo or whenever we attend service, gassho, putting our hands together, and we'd like, he'd like to explain a little bit about that.
So you hold the nenju in your left hand, and you bring your right hand together and gently press your hands together with the thumbs holding it down a little bit. And then place it in front of your chest. So as much as possible at this time, make sure that your fingers are spread open and closed.
そしてお念仏、南無阿弥陀仏、南無阿弥陀仏言います。そしてその後に礼拝をいたしますが、その時にも頭だけを下げるのではなくて、
So when we bow, it's not just bowing with the head, but it's the whole upper torso, and you bow
45 degrees. 45 degrees. そして指先が自分の顔に近づいていったり、指先が下を向いたりこういうことがないようにしっかりとここで固定をした形で大丈夫です
。 So when we bow over, a good way of figuring out if you're bowing the right degree is that your hands should be parallel with the ground because it's 45 degrees and you bow 45 degrees, so then it should be 90 degrees. And then make sure that your hands don't come up to your face or go down, but just place it sturdy and then 45 degrees.
じゃあ一回皆さんやってみましょうか。そう、フェイトボードでございます。
And try that.
ラスト。そして礼拝ですけれども、何万だ何万だ、これ早すぎるんですね。ゆっくりと心気持ちを落ち着かせて、ゆっくりと礼拝をして、ゆっくりと上げる、これをちょっと、ね、心を上げていただける。
So it's a very purposeful vow, and you want to make sure that you're not rushing it. It's not just quickly putting your head down, but gently and slowly bow down, and then gently and slowly come back down.
まあ、そういう基本的な作法というものもあります。これがやっぱり回数をしておりますと、僕はこう慣れてしまうと言いましょうか。気持ちが、まあ、またいつものことというふうな感じで、どうですかね、まあ、慣れてしまうという、いい方になれればいいんですが、悪い方に慣れてしまうという、そういったことになりがちですが、やっぱり礼拝をするというのは尊敬の思いを込めての礼拝になりますから、ゆっくりと落ち着いた形でしていただければと思います。
So one of the problems that he's mentioned this yesterday, and my ears were burning yesterday too, but he says as we get accustomed to things, we have a tendency to get lazy and we have a tendency to rush through things, and as ministers we feel that all the time, but so when we're doing this, it's very purposeful, so you're showing your sign of respect from the bottom of your heart to Amida Buddha. And so, always keeping that in mind as we do our actions. So, it is very deliberate in our actions.
まあ、こうして、この一つの形をとって、ですね、仏様を、まあ、拝むといいましょうか、お念仏をして、と言いますのは、やはり一つ一つの動作というもの、作法というものが、私自身の今の心の状態というものが、現れてしまうということになります。急いでいれば、やっぱりこう、早くなってしまうでしょうし、落ち着いた気持ちであれば、やっぱりゆっくり丁寧な作法というものが行われるでしょうし、その時の自分のその作法一つ一つが、この今の自分自身の気持ち、心の中がどうであるのかっていうことが、こういう一挙手一投足ということでいいんでしょうか、そういったものに現れてくるというのが、この作法でございます。
So in our actions, every little action that we do is actually a manifestation of our inner selfSo when we're feeling rushed or when we do something in a hurry, that also is expressed in our actions. So if we are mindful of our actions, you can also express yourself in a mindful manner. And so the rituals that we do is a form of mindfulness, is mindfulness of paying respect to the two members.
では、まあ、合唱礼拝の姿勢につきましては、皆さんですね、これからもう数えきれないほどこの先もされることかと思います。今、ですね、 申し上げましたことを、まあ、心にちょっと留めていただければと思うことでございます。では続きまして商工、商工の作法ですね、これについて、ちょっと、まあ、昨日もいたしましたけれどもですね、今日の方もいらっしゃるので一度またやってみたいと思います。
So we'll leave that part of the gusho. We'll leave it here and you'll be doing gusho infinite number of times, or you can't count the number of times you'll probably be doing it for the rest of your life, but he'll leave it here, and now he's going to talk about Oshoko or burning of incense. So just for your sake, so you can see, he's changed the direction of the
incense.
So think of Amida Buddha as being over here.
この小光力ですね、ここの2、3歩、まあ、手前で、一旦立ち止まりまして、ここで阿弥陀様に向かって一礼ですね、これをいたします。
So you come up to about 2-3 steps before the incense burner, and you bow 15 degrees by 一遊 or 一礼。
そして、これは浄土真宗の、まあ、決めた作法なんですが、前方に移動する場合には左足から歩を進めるというのが一つの決まり事となっています。
So in the 浄土真宗, this is just out of the denomination has decided, but whenever we move towards the Buddha, we advance with our left foot.
前の方に、進みまして、そして、お香を一回つまんだだけで、中に入れます。この時に、いただいたりとか、2回、3回とかをしません。一回で結構です。
So you come up and you take a pinch of the ground in this sense, just once, and you don't have to bring it to your forehead or you take it multiple times, just once and put it in the ground.
なんで一回でいいのかって言いますと、これは、香りを仏様にお供えをするということなんですね。ですので、その2回3回して煙をいっぱい立てればそれでいいというわけではなくて、昔からインドはその大変暑い国で、そして大衆とかそういったものが、ものすごくですね、言ってみれば気にかかるようなものでございます。そして、自分自身がこのまあ、大衆に自分のインドの方では自分の身を清めるというふうな意味もあったのでしょう、けれどもそれを香りを仏様にお供えをするという意味で、ですからもうそんな2回3回をする必要もなく1回で。
So what, the reason why you only do it once is that the whole meaning of burning incense is you're making an offering to the Buddha, offering of the aroma of the incense.And it's not the point to get as much smoke as you can get, or just that giving of the aroma. And so in India, in the times of Buddha, obviously being a very tropical and hot country, the human hygiene was not as good. So the people had the body odor, and so it was a part of a purification ritual also to burn the incense. But for Jodo Shinshu in particular, is the offering of the aroma that you're doing. So once is enough, not two, three times.
そして一回、消耗いたしまして、自分一人だけの時には、消耗した後に蓋を閉めてから合掌、そして念仏、礼拝をいたします。自分の後に、2人3人と人が続く場合には、蓋は開けたままで結構です。
So if the incense, the lid of the ground incense is closed, and if it's just yourself only, you open it up and you leave it hanging like it is, and you take a pinch and sprinkle over, and then you do the gusho. Oh, before you do the gusho, you close the lid and then do the gusho.But if there are others who follow you, you can leave the lid open as such. And you always leave it
on the lid sort of hanging off the And the last person would then close the lid.
そして、合掌をしまして、念仏、そして第2回。終わりましたら、今度、後ろに下がるときには、右足からまた2、3歩戻って、そして一流をして、そして自分の席に戻ります。So
after you've done the 合掌, you come back up. Then when we go back, you don't turn around and go back. You actually back up, facing the Buddha, but you back up with your right foot going back first, and you take a couple steps back, and then you just bow. And then you go back. So this is the standard way of doing burning incense according to Jodo Shishu, and please keep this in mind in the future when you go about the incense. Sideways, so moving out of the way, right? Doesn't have to be directly back.
では、基本的な作法で皆さんが、よくされるであろうですね、そういうところをさ、例えばちょっと説明をさせていただきました。で、まあ、そう、
we'll leave the ritual part there and we'll talk now a little bit more about chanting.
まあ、昨日もちょっと説明の方だけをさせていただきました。皆さんが、このよくお勤めされるのは、昇進芸であろうかと思います。まあ、ちょっと歴史ですね。昇進芸であろうかと思いますけれども、その昇進芸は、略した言い方でして、昇進念仏芸が、
So he heard from yesterday, and he spoke a little bit about yesterday as well, but one of our primary chants that we do is the Shoshin Ye. And so he wants to talk a little bit about the Shoshin Ye. And the proper title for the Shoshin Ye is Shoshin Nembutsu Ye.
そしてこの昇進念仏芸は、宗祖であります親鸞聖人が、まあ、お書物の中、教行信証という、正式名称、建城の真実、教行証本類ですけれども、その中の行間の一番最後にお書きになられた、御門でございます。それを、蓮如上人、第8代目の蓮如上人が、1473年、 その時から、この浄土真宗のお勤めに、朝と夜のそのお勤めに、この昇進念仏芸と和山念仏、和山をつけて、お勤めをするようになりました。
So what we call 昇進芸 is the proper title. Is that actually part of a much larger piece? Which is what we call the canon of Jodo Shinshu. It's the true teaching, practice, and attainment of the Pure Land Way. And it comes at the end of the second chapter, the chapter on practice. And it's a song that was written by Shinran Shonin. But it wasn't chanted until 1473, when the eighth Monshu, Denyo Shonin, this scroll is over to the
the love. Menryo Shonin said that as followers of Jodo Shinshu, we should be chanting twice a day, morning, once at night, and once in the evening. And his recommendation was that we chant this Shoshin Nembutsu together, that was with Ma Shinnam, followed by what we call Nembutsu and Wasan, the songs or the poems written by Shinnam. So that's what, how the Shoshin Nembutsu together, we do the Shoshin and the Wasan together.
皆さんも唱えられておることかと思いますが、昇進念仏の中で、前道の組を仏称の所、その前で一旦お勤めが止まります。そして前道から一行を長生人が唱えて、また次の行から全員で唱えるという、そういう唱え方になっておりますけれども、これは、先ほども申し上げました、蓮如上人から、それ以前は蓮如上人以前は王城来さんということを常に唱えておりました。けれども、この蓮如上人が来さんを辞めて、辞めてと言いましょうか、の代わりに、この昇進行を用いて、そしてまた親鸞上人が、この前道大師の浄土教学というものを大変重要視されていたということがございます。ですので、前道大師にそれだけ敬意を払って、
So if you open your books to if you open your books to page 63, it has the Shoshinge, and there's different versions of how you chant it. So 63 is Gyofu, and you'll notice that on page 64, in the middle of page 64, it says number 14 on. Do you see where it says number 14? And it says Zendo Dokumyo Bushogi. Do you all see that one line? Okay. So the Shoshinge, how it's chanted is that the first line, just the leader chants, and then everybody joins in. And then in the middle of the chant, everybody stops, and then from Zendo Dokumyo Bushogi, again, just the leader chants. And the reason why that's done, when Rinyo Shoni said we should chant this together, what he was doing was he was paying special respect to Zendo Daishi. He was the fifth patriarch of Jodo Shinshu, of the seven patriarchs. And Shinran had a particular respect for Zendo, or Shantao as he's known in Chinese. And up until the time of Renyo Shomi, in Jodo Shinshu, what was common was that everybody chanted, there was a chant that was created by Zendo that she called Ojo Daisan. And it's a much longer chant, and it's broken up into six parts. And it was chanted six times throughout the day. They had so late afternoon or dusk, early evening, mid evening, then late evening, and then early morning, and then mid morning. So it was broken up six times a day, and they would chant part of this Ojo Raisan six times a day. So we think of the Muslims being very dedicated by praying five times a day. You can imagine how difficult it would have been chanting six times a day. So Renyo Shoni said we should chant just twice a day and chant what Shinran Shoni had written, which is this Shoshin Nembutsu, once in the morning, once at night. However, he also wanted to make that respect to Zendo Daishi, who had written that previous chant that they were chanting. So that's why it stops right before Zendo Daishi, and then the leader reads that one line by himself to, as a sign of respect to Zendo.
まあ、そういった形でいろいろな、お勤めというものがこの浄土真宗本願寺派の中にもございます。 この浄土真宗、皆さんも昨日伺ったんですが、この三部浄というのを皆さんもですね、一緒に唱えられるということを聞きました。このいろんなこういう節がついておるんですが、浄土真宗本願寺派のこのお勤め、称名と呼ばれるものなんですけれども、これは日本にございます、比叡山というところがある、そこに天台宗というところがございます、総本山です。このカナダにも天台宗はあるんでしょうか。
天台宗はないんだろう。
まあ、日本にこの仏教が入ってきたときに、この天台宗、比叡山と、そして高野山というところですね、この2つ、真言宗になりますが、この2つのところが、それぞれ二大仏教といいましょうか、総本山といいましょうか、そういったところになりまして、でこの天台宗のお勤め、称名というものを浄土真宗は、浄土真宗が受け入れたといいましょうか、伝えてくださって、そして、まあ、いろんなちょっとお勤めの仕方は、変化をしておりますけれども、この1000年以上前のそういうお勤め、天台宗からのお勤めというものが、中心になっております。そして時代が現代に近づくにつれまして、その浄土真宗の教義、親鸞聖人の教え、ですね、それに合った御門というものも用い出しましたし、そして、ちょっと今ではちょっと残念なんですが、簡略化されたようなそういう節というようなものになっております。
So, in 浄土真宗 we have many different chants.And he had heard during his visit here that we often chant the Sambujo in our services, and including the Sambujo, the chanting of Jodo Shinshu actually comes from what we call the Tendai tradition in Japan. Just east of Kyoto, northeast of Kyoto, there is a place called Mount Hiei, and there is Mount Hiei is where the Tendai school of Buddhism.Was founded and where they have their mother temple there. It's one of the older schools of Buddhism, and that's where Shinran came from originally, the Tendai school. And so our chanting style comes from that Tendai school of Buddhism. Over the many centuries, however, they revised the chanting to modernize it more.And according to Sensei, unfortunately, a lot of the chanting has been simplified for the modern era. So the chants that we do, you might find it difficult, but that's actually simplified from what they were originally.
で、この三部浄につきましてですね、まあそういう、遠い昔から、この受け継いできた、その称名でございます。そして皆さんもこの三部浄をよく唱えられるということで、今日は、この三部浄と一回これの練習をですね、してみたいと思いますが、この三部浄、皆さんこのどうですかね、下に英訳されてる、これ英訳されてるかな、はい、この英訳されてる部分を読んでいただいて、うんと思わない、思われたことないでしょう。浄土真宗は皆一物というふうに阿弥陀様のみというふうに言われておりますが、この五門を見ますと、部浄、弥陀如来、釈迦如来、十方如来というですね、出てきます。浄土真宗は阿弥陀様だけなのに、なぜこの弥陀如来、釈迦如来、十方如来に来てください。部浄というのは、まあ、濃い願い、まあ、招くというふうな、そういう意味がございますが、阿弥陀様だけなのになぜこれだけの仏様、如来様なのかっていうのを思われたことないでしょうか。
So, because we chant Sambujo here during our services, we would like to practice that with everybody today. It's on page 29 of your books. If you can open up page 29 of your books. If you look at the English translation at the bottom, It says there, it talks about welcoming Amida Buddha, Shakyamuni Buddha, and the Buddhas of the Ten Directions. And he says that he's asked if any of you have ever questioned that, because in Jodo Shinshu, we normally talk about only all we need is the workings of Amida Buddha. So why are we inviting the Shakyamuni and the Buddhas of the Ten Directions to come join us?
この理由といたしましては、これもともと天台から、天台宗から来たものでして、天台宗の方には、四部城というのがございます。天台宗の方では、この弥陀如来、釈迦如来、十方如来、そして観音聖子初代菩薩等というですね、この四つがございます。 それを観音聖子初代菩薩等を省きまして、そしてこの三部城というふうに、この本願寺の方では務めてはいるんですけれども、その理由といたしましては、阿弥陀様をはじめ、別に浄土真宗は他の諸仏方を否定しているわけではないんですけれども、阿弥陀様はいつでもそこでもいらっしゃるんですが、 すでにこういう釈迦如来でありましたり、十方如来もあらゆる、仏様方というのがすでにこの道場に、満ち満ちているというそういう思いを持って、自分自身の心を正しくして、そしてその法要に、法要を務めるというですね、そういう自分の気持ちを正すという、 仏様方はすでに満ち満ちているんだ、この場に満ちているんだということを心がけてお勤めをするという、そういう思いを持ってこの三部城をお勤めいたします。So
the reason why we have all these other Buddhas listed in this is because this actually predates Jodo Shinshu. It comes from this Tendai school, and in there they talk about four types of deities that Amida, Shakyamuni, the ten Buddhas, as well as the Bodhisattva. But when we chant this, they've taken out away the Bodhisattva names and they chant these three. But what this is trying to represent to us is that Jodo Shinshu doesn't necessarily deny all the other Buddhas, but we welcome and we realize that we are surrounded by the Dharma, including all these Buddhas from the Ten Directions. And it's a way for us to reflect upon ourselves that when we attend a ceremony or service, that we are purifying our hearts, our minds, being guided by all the Dharma that surrounds us constantly. So it's a reminder more to our own self that when we come in here, we are humbling ourselves or refocusing ourselves, if you will, so that we have a proper mindset as we listen to the Dharma.
では、一度この三部城をですね、まあ行くだけになりますが、ちょっと唱えてみます。皆様方もですね、一度ちょっと耳で聞いていただいてですね。
So he's going to chant the Sambujo by himself first, so just listen first, and then we'll practice that.
シュットンと言いまして、出る音なんですよ。これ、ラーの音。So
the opening pitch is the ラー, ドレミファソラ, it comes up from ラー.
Oh. あと2句続くことになります。
So this is just the first verse and then you have two verses.
で、この三下落の三のところなんですけれども、ここ3、この三下落の三のところで、これ皆さん、ケハと言います。これは、花びらを、もともとは花びらをかたどったものなんですけれども、まあ、インドの方では、まあ、非常に暑い国です。ですから、お花っていうものも、そうそう手に入るようなものではないんですけれども、でも、そのインドでは、これ、古代インドからの風習と言いましょうか。自分の先生でありましたりとか、ですね、まあ、尊敬するような方、そして、まあ、当時もそうだったんでしょうけど、位の高いとされるような方が歩かれる時には、その周り歩くところを花びらを持ってパーッとこう散らしながら、その道を花びらで埋めていたというですね、そういう風習がありました。その風習を仏教が取り入れまして、そしてそれが、本当に大まかに言いますとインド、中国、日本の仏教が伝わる中で、こういう日本もその花びらを散らす、そして、花びらを持ってその道場を荘厳をするというような風習、それが仏教とともに、仏教の中で、伝わってきまして、そして花びらをいちいちそういう回数多くなってきたんでしょう。花びらが、まあその想像使うことできませんので、こういう紙で作ったケハと呼ばれるもの、これを散らすようになりました。
So you may have noticed when we do the sampujo, sometimes the ministers in the altar throw these paper petals. They're in the shape of it's supposed to be the shape of flower petals. And the tradition in India was that.India being a very tropical, hot country, when you have a great teacher or master walking, the tradition was to spread flower petals in front of them. And so as a gesture of respect, to honor the Buddhas as they enter the hondo, they would throw these flower petals, but because over time it became easier to make paper petals. So,we still have that as part of our tradition where when we chant this, and maybe next time we could get pretty sensitive, get all of you to make flower petals, and then when you chant it together,
I brought
Fuji sensei. Sorry. Yeah, but the petals are part of the tradition, and so when you're welcoming the Buddhas, you spread these.
ですからこの弥陀如来、釈迦如来、十方如来のこの如来方がすでにこの道場に満ち満ちている中をこの花びらを持って荘厳をするということですね。
So you're using these petals to spread the whole hondo where the Buddhas are coming, and that's part of respecting that sense of honor.こちらでは日本でもそうだと思うんですが、僧侶が同じになってるんですけど、この小本さんにもそういうことを参加してもらってもいいですか。 So yeah, I asked him whether, like, here as well in Japan, this is a tradition where just the ministers are doing it in the altar. So I asked him if it's okay for the members to do it as well. I said, yeah, there's no problem with that. So you make flower petals and everybody can do it.
ただしこの三下巻くんですが、浄土真宗では巻き方が
So in 浄土真宗 it's done with dignity and grace. So just like a flower petal would just gently fall from a tree. So that's what this is about.
ダメなのか。これは浄土真宗、他のところではやってますが、浄土真宗本願寺は。
So he said, in other denominations, they tend to be a little more flamboyant and they'll throw it up. But he says, Jodo Shinshu is a denomination of grace. And so we just gently drop. So it's more colorful maybe to throw it up, but there were actually people that it hit in the head and they got paper cut from it, so just gently throw
it up.では、皆様方も 実際にこの三部条を一回唱えてみましょう。話聞いてるばっかりではちょっと眠たくなってくるかもわかりませんので、皆さん、大きな声、大きな声。そして、この、昨日もちょっと申し上げたんですが、この声を、まあ言ってみれば発声法ということでも言うんでしょう。声を出すときに、できれば、 出るわけはないですが、お腹から声を出していただきたい。いっぱい息を吸って、ですね。そして自分の上半身をスピーカーにするような、そういうつもりで、ですね。ですから、お腹のちょっと下の方にグッとこう力を入れて、ちょっと力を入れて、そして上半身は楽にして、そして、声を出す。そして、ですから、 あまり体がこう固まっていますと、やっぱり喉にも負担がかかってまいります。ですから、そして、この、できれば、まあ人それぞれ、声質というものがあるんですけれども、無理に怒鳴るような、そういう声ではなくて、ですね、やはり、自分自身の、 その阿弥陀様を敬うその気持ちというものが自分の声となって現れるようになります。気持ちを表していただきたいと思います。So
just listening to me, I'm sure you're getting sleepy. So we want you to practice together sambujo. Now, in order to chant, you have to try to get your voice from your stomach. And not literally, you understand, but what you want to do is put a little strength in your abs here. But you want to react your upper body. If you're too tense, it will damage your vocal cords. Now, you want to chant out loud as you can, but you don't want to be yelling. It's chanting. What you're doing is you are honoring or you are paying homage to the Buddha. So with that feeling of paying homage to the Buddha, chant out loud.
まあ、私は先ほども紹介していただいた中で、ゴンシキ指導所というところにおります。そして、その中で、大内先生もそうでしたが、生徒さんがいらっしゃいます。その人たちに私よく言うのが、 自分のその思いというものを声として表せるような表現者になってくださいというようなことをよく言います。ただただ書かれてあるその音、そして音の上げ下げ、それができれば、お勤めができたというものではありません。自分の心の中、そして阿弥陀様を敬う気持ちというものを自分の声として表現をするということですね。 それが一番お勤めの中では大切なことです。ただし、自分はこう表現したいからといって、音の高さであったりとか、こういう節ね、それを勝手に作っていいというものではございません。ルールにのっとった上で自分自身の思いを表現して、仏塔三段をするという。 これが、浄土真宗のお勤めの1から10までが、もう仏塔三段でございます。ですから自分自身のそのありがたい仏様の前に座らせていただいて、お勤めをするというですね、その気持ちというものを自分の声として表す、表現者になる。皆さんもそういう一つのアーティストです。 表現者になっていただきたい。
So, as Izui-sensei was introduced as the teacher in the department of rituals and chanting, and he often tells his students, including Oji Sensei, that when we chant, what we are doing is expressing our inner feelings, the inner feelings of humbleness as well as our feelings of expressing gratitude to for us to be able to be here in the presence or in front of Amida Buddha. And so when you're chanting, always have that in mind that this is not just looking at the notes and the chord, the melody, and thinking, okay, I'm just following this and I've got this, but it's your expressing, and that's why I use the word artist, is that you are expressing your inner feelings of gratitude, your inner feelings of humbleness, your inner feelings of appreciation as we honor the Buddha. And so with this in mind, as we chant, we try to be mindful of this.
そしてもう一つ大切なことなんですが、皆様方今こうして本堂、ね、トロント仏教館のこの本堂の方にいらっしゃいます。今何人いらっしゃるんですかね、ざっと見て23人いらっしゃるかな、ですけれども、この皆さんがこのお勤めは阿弥陀様を中心として、この一つの本堂という儀礼空間の中で、皆さんの心を一つにしていただきたいんです。皆さんの心を一つにして、仏徳三段、それぞれが仏徳三段をしていただきたい。早くこの時間過ぎないかな、早く終わらないかなとかって考えながらするのではなくてですね、やっぱりこの非日常的なこの空間というものはこの本堂儀礼空間なんです。そして、この儀礼空間に身を置いた私というのは仏様、阿弥陀様を目の前にして、何なんだろうこれ、分かる、理屈じゃなくてありがたいな、手が合わさるな、気がついたら手が合わさってきたなというふうな空間がこの儀礼空間になるんです。ですからそこには、やっぱり皆さんのここに集っておられる皆さんが法要お勤めということをきっかけとして、皆さんの心が合わさる、これがやっぱり、日常的な空間で行われるものであって、お勤めであろうかと思います。
So this is considered to be a spiritual space. And another, one of the aspects is our relationship with Amida Buddha. We come here to have this very special relationship. But also, as members, as Sangha, it's a place where our thoughts and our hearts come together as one.So we are honoring the Buddha together as one, not as individuals. So if somebody's thinking, oh, I wish this would hurry up and finish, or you know, I have to go there, or whatever, your thoughts aren't here at the present. So it's also important to reflect on that as well, is that it's not just you, but you're here together. We are here together in this very special space that is not your common everyday space. So we take away our rational mind while we're in here. Our logical mind gets put on the back burners and come to that spiritual mind where we're thinking of coming together in oneness, of humbleness, of gratitude as we chant together.
やっぱりその宗教と言いますのはやっぱり心がどうでしょう、中心となって出発点となっているものだと思います。単に、形骸化されたようなものだけに終わるんじゃなくて、やっぱり宗教というのはやっぱり儀式儀礼、それはやっぱり心の中が形になって現れるものでございます。ですからね、皆様の方もこの本当にこの仏様、この儀礼空間を大切にして、その中に、その空間の中に自らが溶け込むとでもいいんでしょうか、心を合わせていただければ。
So the whole idea of rituals and chanting, etc., is to make us understand as a religion that it's much more than just scholarly knowledge or just an understanding, but you are actually receiving this spiritual awakening. And so as part of that, rituals play a very important role in that, and that we are putting away or putting that logical mind on the back burner and coming to more of a spiritual mind. So if you're ready, sit up straight and
すいません、お勤めしますと言いながらも、もう一つだけ言わせてください。So
I apologize, let me just say one more thing about posture.
椅子に腰掛けた姿勢がございます。十分に深く腰を掛けて、そして背筋を伸ばして、足はちょっと後ろの方に引いて座っていただきます。So
just sit up straight, and your feet both on the floor. It could be a little bit of the back of the feet.
はい、それでは今度の相談をいたします。
So we'll go through the whole thing together.
まあ、これ皆さん唱えることはないんでしょうけれども、この、 入道場のところなんですけれども、そこに入移りというですね、ですから音を本当に上の方に移すようなイメージで、音を変化させていきます。
So the move part you want to make it so that the transitionsNaturally from the lower note to the higher note.
そして音がその次の音に移ったならば、まあ早いタイミングで次の言葉に入る。
So after you've gone to the higher note, then quickly you go on to the next word.
では2句目ですね。釈迦如来。
So we'll do the second verse of 釈迦如来。
最初から皆さんで一緒にやってみましょう。
二
句目。 と申し上げたんですが、こういうお勤めの最後、もう終わりのところっていうのは、自分の声を出さなくなったとしても、意識だけをスーッとつなげておいています。それがやっぱり、一つの間合いとなって現れたりとか、で、自分自身の気持ちを収めるというふうなところにもつながっていきます。
So the last, syllable of the word, chanting, it just doesn't drop off, but you, even though the sound stops, you want to, in your heart, you want to have the feeling that you're still just gently closing up. So it's not just a sudden drop.
まあ、あの今皆さんが、よく、まあ、お勤めされる三部長ですね、一緒に、お勤めしましたけれども、やっぱりその称名というのは先ほども最初にも申し上げましたけれども、やっぱり自分自身の心というものがやっぱり自分自身の声となって現れて仏徳三段をさせていただく、この一つにつきます、ですから大きな声 ですね、今コトコトコトというんじゃなくて、小さな声ブンブンブンだけじゃなくて、ルーッと大きな声です。ここをね、大きな声でグッドサンドしていただければと思います。
So, although we use the sambucho as an example right now, with all the chanting that we have, we are paying homage to the Buddha. So, make sure you chant out loud with that feeling of paying homage to the Buddha, not just mumbling in and doing it very quietly, because you're not paying homage to anybody that way. So I said to make sure you try as best as you can to your ability to chant out loud in a nice loud voice to pay homage to the Buddha.
ではまああのですね、照明の方はこれぐらいさせていただきました。これでまたあのちょっと、五分章ですか、こちらの方も、まあ、ちょっとだけ、まあ、時間もちょっと迫っておりますけれども、五分章のことについてもちょっとだけさせていただきたいと思います。
So, we'll leave the chanting part here for now. And what you'd like to do is just explain a little about what we call the 五分章, or the letters of 伝妙書に. This is also traditionally something that we ministers would read like at the funeral time. You know, we're familiar with the white ashes.
はい、この白骨章についてですね、今からちょっと、まあ、私拝読をさせていただきたいと思います。この白骨章はここにもどういうんでしょうか、悲しい縁ではございますけれども、葬儀の際にですね、皆様方もよくあの耳にされる、聞かれる御文ではないかと思います。その内容をですね、まあ、言ってみましたら、その人間の、まあ、本当に儚い、本当に一言で言ってみましたら、本当に、人間自身のその儚い命、今は健康で、自分自身大丈夫と思っているかもわからないけれど、次の瞬間どうなってしまうかもわからない私自身のこの命、この儚さっていうものですね、そういったことも書かれておるところでございます。この白骨の五分章が、まあ、書かれたというですね、まあ、この先ほどもおっしゃいましたけれども、第八代目の蓮如上人が、この全国の、御門とかとメンバーの方々に向けて書かれたそのお手紙でございます。
So this Later on, White Ashes, we traditionally read it at the funeral services, and it talks about the fleeting nature of life, how it's incalculable. We might be healthy one moment, but none of us knows what's going to happen the next moment. And it was written by the eighth Monshu, Daniel Shoni.
まあ、ちょっと私事でこのような場でちょっと申し上げていいのかどうかわからないんですけど、この白骨の五分章は私も本当にもう聞くありがたいんですけれども、聞くと 私の自分自身の父親のことを思い出してしまって、まあ私の20年ちょっとぐらい前に父親を亡くしたんですけれども、まあその時にですね、やっぱりこの白骨の5文書、葬儀の時には本当にバタバタしていて、なかなかこれを味わうということができなかったんですけど、ちょっと落ち着いてからこの白骨の5文書を改めて黙読をいたしました。 涙止まらなかったです。やっぱりこの人間の命っていうものを本当に考えさせられる、こういう5文書、私未だにやっぱりこの5文書、ありがたいんですが、ちょっと余分のが、辛い時もありますかね。<笑>まあこれはキリストの命というところに深く根ざしたところの5文であろうかと思います。
So it doesn't know if it's appropriate or not, but he says this on why he asks this letter in particular has very personal meaning to him. As when his father passed away 20 years ago, he said that during the time of the funeral, you know, you're all busy with the preparing for funerals and all that, so he didn't really get a chance to reflect on it. But afterwards, upon reading the words of it, he couldn't stop crying. And he said that even now, although he reads this, there's a part of it that finds difficulty in reading it, and that it talks about really our human existence. And he asked that, you know, please read the English translation and really reflect upon what it's saying there.
この書かれたのは、まあ、この五文書、五文書全体がですね、これは、例の書にお書きになられて、いろいろな約束言葉、まあ、ございます。その余分に際してですね、中切りと呼ばれるものもありますし、大切りと呼ばれるものもあります。これは、 まあ一つのアクセントというふうにしようか。これは、日本のその京都、例の書に京都の方です。で、その京言葉というものを真似たアクセントとしてですね、こういう大喜利でありましたり、中切りと呼ばれるですね、こういった表現方法があります。まあこれを初めて聞くと、何それというような感じを持たれるかもわかりませんけれども、まあ、 本当にこれは今これこんな勝手なことを言ったらそこからかもわかりませんけれども、なぜこの五文書自体がこういう京都の言葉をアクセントを用いているのかと言いますと、これは本当に私の勝手な考え方かもわかりませんが、蓮如上人が未だに直に私たちにこの言葉を説いてくださっているというふうにも受け取れるんじゃないか、そういうふうな感じ。
When reading these letters of Renyo, there's some rules, if you will, of how to read them, and there's actual inflections of the voice, and there's what they call the small inflection, or nakagiri, versus what they call the large inflection, which is ogiri. And this actually originates from at the time of that Renyo was alive, there was a type of speaking called Kyoto speech. And it's the dialect of Kyoto, at that time of Renyo. So it's based on that the rules of how to read this come about. And Izui-sensei is saying that, you know, this is his personal view, but he believes that the reason why we have all these inflections and changes in tone of the reading is that what we're trying to actually imagine is Daniel is speaking to us here today. So that's why it's going back to his way of talking at that time.
この五文書というのは全員で読むことはありません。たった一人がその読むというのが基本になる。
So, 五文書 is that these letters are not to be read by everybody together, but one person listens, reads it, and everybody else listens.
で、この五分章で、この五分章は皆さんも拝読していただいて結構なんです。十分あのお坊さんたちが、読むっていう先輩とか特技じゃないんです。皆さんもやっぱりこれをあの本当にどうですかね、法要中に読むというわけではないんですが、ご自宅で、ですねこれを見て、読んでいただいて十分それだけ。
So these letters, we always said, you know, one person means everybody listens. It doesn't mean that you can't read it, right? So he said, please, you know, whether it's here or at your home, please read these letters because they tell us some very important things.
で、これを、昔は日本でもその朗読というのが当たり前の世界だったんですね。今は黙読が中心となってしまっています。朗読と言いますと、自分が声に出して読むということなんです。周りにいる人たちは、イヤホンでもそのものが聞こえてくるんですね。ですから、聞く意識があろうがなかろうが聞こえてくるものに関してうんとこう耳を傾ける、そしていつしかその気持ちが合わさっているというところがあるんですね。ただこの今はもう黙読一人でこうずっとこう声あの黙読するというのが主流になっております。 で、ですからこの声に出してこの五分章を読むということ自体はこれ先からずっと言っておりますけれども、この蓮如上人のこの書かれたこの文章を中心としてその場空間にいる人たちが心を一つにするということです、ですからこの五文章を拝読をする者は拝読をする人は何も間違えずに五文を読めるのがこれは当たり前のことなんですが、間違わずに読んだから、はい、読めたという、そういうものではないんですね。自分自身がこの五問の内容を味わっているものを自分自身の声として表して、そして聞いておられる方の耳を通して心の中に届けるというのが、この五文章を拝読をするという意味なんです。単にセレモニーが、形だけのもので、読んだ、はい、終わりました、じゃあではないんです。やっぱりその拝読をする側はまずは自分が味わって、そしてそれを声として表して聞いておられる方の心の中に届けている、それが一番この読み物と呼ばれるものがの中で一番大切なところであり一番難しいものであるということです。
So the Gomonshou The country of Japan used to be traditionally a country where the art of oratorial presentation was very important. Even here, they used to have oratorial competitions. And so to be able to speak out loud was very important. Now today, we're getting to a culture where more reading is more where people read a lot, but they don't necessarily vocalize what they are reading. But by vocalizing it, those around you hear what you are reading. And when you are reading these letters, it's not just to be able to read the letters, but it's internalizing the contents of the letter and then expressing with your feelings, the words of what Daniel has been saying. So at the Hongwanji, when they read these letters, the minister that's reading it is trying to express his feelings as if he was actually Daniel showing. And it's the most important part is to try to get across to the heart of those listening the meaning of what you're trying to say. And at the same time, it's probably the most difficult thing to do is to get that across. Not just
reading and understanding up here, but for people to feel it down here.
まあ、この伝え方、表現の仕方というのは人それぞれあろうかと思います。今私がこの白骨の語文章を、まあ、味わう中で、表現といいましょうか、伝えたいというですね。それを、まあ、人それぞれ違うとは思いますが、今の私、今のこの現時点での私のこの入る語文章、白骨章ですね。これを
So even though every person who presents this will have their own internalization and own expression, I'd like for you to listen how he feels about this at this moment. So he's going to read the letter.
Sore.
Oh, no. 形骸化されたようなものではなくて、やっぱり自分の心が、姿となって形となってこの空間となって現れるんだということですので、儀礼が伴わない宗教というものは多分世界広しといえどもないと思っております。
それはやっぱり心が元となって宗教というものが、出てきたと生まれたというふうに信じております、その心が突き動かすものはやっぱり儀礼であって、そしてこういうお勤めであって、それを表現する、そういうものであろうかと思っております。ですから皆さんもぜひぜひ本当に、このお勤めというものを通してですね、当然共学というものも 大事なんですけれども、まずはこういうお勤めを通して、ですね、まあ仏様を本当に敬う、賛美する、そういう気持ちをずっと持ち続けていただければなというふうに思うことであります。
So whether it be chanting or ritual itself, it's the whole point is not necessarily just learning aboutthe proper way to step, or you know, that's secondary. What's really important is that through your actions, you're expressing your feelings, and that's where the rituals actually were born, through this sense of praising the Buddha, or to express our gratitude, our humbleness. It took the form of rituals. So.The rituals are important in that it allows us to show through our actions our feelings towards the Dharma. And so keeping that in mind, you know, the teachings are also very important, but you can also express your feelings through these actions. And so when we do chanting or when we talk about rituals, please remember that the heart of it is always that.We are expressing our feeling of praising the Buddha, or our feeling of gratitude, or our expression of humbleness towards the Dharma. So this would conclude his lecture, but does anybody have questions for Sensei? And it could be any wide, you'd be amazed at what he will be able to answer. So any questions?
お答えできる範囲で
whatever he could answer to this.
大丈夫ですか。
Okay.
Reverend Brad, will you be treated to musical
material? Unfortunately, there was a little bit of miscommunication, and his instrument is back at the hotel. So we won't be able to do.And Ochi sensei is too shy to do it on his own. Did you want to do
it? No. Yes. Yeah. That leads to an open invitation to Sensei Reverend Izui to come back again.
だから雅楽を演奏してくれますかという質問で、まあ、ミスコミュニケーションでその楽器がホテルに置いたということで。He's going to actually borrow Ochi Sensei's instrument and just do a little bit. Sorry. If he brought it to you, then next time, please come back.
Thank you.
So does that mean if he plays now, there's not a next time?
So the teaser
is
better to come back next time. Yes. One thing
だけ条件がある。その12年間の間を空けないように。
He also has a date in Montana.
So I should let those who are here know that one of the places we took Sensei to was Montana. And you might ask why you were going to Montana. Well, 12 years ago when they came, I took four, and he was probably one of the smaller ones. There were four ministers from the rituals department. I took them to Montana and said, all you can eat grills. And I've never seen anybody eat as much.
many years as the sensei, so we had to go back to Montana and start to get back to the same restaurant. Unfortunately, he didn't have the ribs.
Oh.
Oh, ribs, the ribs. He ate a lifetime worth of ribs last time, so didn't have to. As Larry had mentioned, he actually remembered exactly where we sat last time, too. Just to let you know, this instrument he's going to be playing is called a chiriki. You might see the steaming hot water or is that what So what they're doing is they have a reed that they blow into it, and they have to expand it a little bit, and so that's why they keep warming up before they play.
All right. Question? How does sensei feel, and you as well, about not burning incense any longer? Like, I really miss it. I understand why you're not doing it, but it must feel very strange to walk into our temple and not be able to smell that.
I'll ask him first. So the answer was, he understands, the whole idea was the offering of the aroma as part of one of our offerings. And so, if you don't burn it, then the aroma's not going to come out. So personally, he would like to have the incense burned, but he also understands if there are people that have severe allergies and have an allergic reaction, then that's not good either. But as from a personal perspective, he said, he would prefer to have the burning. But from my perspective, incense actually had a very interesting or background in Japan, in that they still do have it, but not as many. They used to have incense stores. And like we have David's Teas over here, where you go and you get a blend of different teas? People actually used to go and buy their own blend of incense, and they used to carry a pouch with them. And so it was actually an ingenious way. Today when we go to visit somebody's house, we have to take wine, or we have to take chocolates, or whatever it might be. People can go to somebody's house with just a little pouch of incense. And the first place you go to when you go and visit somebody in Japan, they're like a relative, they probably take you to, they call it the altar room, the Buddha room, and literally Buddha room, Butsuma. And you go to the family altar to pay respect to the Buddha and the ancestors. And so they would bring out the little pouch of incense, and they would make their offering of their own unique aroma. So today we simplified it. We have the incense here all the time. But the whole tradition was to bring your own little aroma to as an offering, as a gift, right? So that's where it comes from. So. Myself, we still burn incense in Steveston, and I've actually had nobody complain to us about this. And the one thing you can do, one thing we do, is when we have large services, is we put the charcoal briquette in it. And so the charcoal briquette itself doesn't smoke. It's only when the people burn the incense that you'll have a pop of smoke. But then that disappears relatively quickly. It's the long stick incense that burns produces smoke while it's burning throughout. So that might be an option, is just put a charcoal brick in there. But again, depending on the temple, you have different policies, and so there's no right or wrong to that. But I prefer to have things as myself.
Just one quick short one. When you make gohan at night for supper and you put the gopang in your kutsan, when must it come down by? By that night? Sometimes
well,
I forget. And
actually, that's another thing. Gopang is one of the things. When you make gohan at night for supper, gopang is one of the things. When you make gohan at night for supper,
gopang is one of the お昼には下げていただくというのがあるんですけれども、まあ、時代によって、まあ、今の時代本当にもう朝、うん、その時間がないとか、という都合でどうしても夜にしか上げる時間がないという場合にはあのこれはやっぱり、お供えをさせていただいてそして手を合わせて、お念仏していただいて、してもうあとそのもしかしたらもう それをそのまま下げていただいていただいてもらっても結構です。
So actually, I feel the same way too. The rice is supposed to be offered first thing in the morning, but because of our culture and in Japan too, people may not eat rice. In the morning anymore, but it shows that we've gone from Buddha-centric to human-centric, and that before in Japan, first thing they would do is offer the rice to the Buddha, okay? And then they would take it off before lunch and then have it as part of the meals. So if you're giving the rice at the evening, we also don't want people to waste things, so it is important to take it down and have it after you present it to the Buddha. Have it as part of your meal as well. Take it down right away, and then you can eat it at that, because you won't be eating it until next morning if you don't do it. Take it down in the evening, and then it will be a part of my next meal. So it makes sense to you have to be practical about things as well, and you want. Make sure, but the point is the gesture of presenting it to the Buddha before you eat it yourself is very important. Is that the Buddha comes first, or the Dharma comes first? So we're respecting that.
Thank you so much.
So it's more than how long you're leaving it up. It's your offering, and I often say that what's the most important offering you're giving is the offering of your heart. Okay, so if your thought is into that offering, that's what the point of the offering is, right? So it's not just something that you're doing out of obligation. Oh, okay, I have to put the rice up here, and then. Forget about it, you know, that's not the point, it's you're offering your heart. And so that's the important aspect, so whatever you're giving off. So it doesn't have to be right.
Okay. Oh no, in the morning I put a little fruit there, but when I finish my service I take this fruit out.
Yeah, and that's fine. So the only thing that we recommend is don't put in meat products because it could rot and, you know, go bad, but if I did, in fact, I think it was Akira's mom. Akira asked me when we did a memorial service for his mom, you know, what did she bring for offering? I said, well, bring what she likes. So he brought a bunch of arrow bark. I still remember chocolate box because that was her favorite. So, you know, that kind of offering is the heart.
このエテンラクというのは、ものすごく古いものでございまして、さまざまな日本の音楽に影響を与えたものでございます。まあ、それをちょっと聞かせていただきますが、 吹いている最中私の顔は見ないでください
。不細工。He's gonna now play one of the most traditional Japanese songs. It's called Ikenbaku, and it's the basis for many Japanese art songs. And he asked the one thing is why he's playing, don't look at his face because he doesn't look too good. He says, well.
So, despite that, kind of put it in that way. This actually has three lines to this, like one, two, three lines. And you remember back to the first line and the second line again. And it really brought memories back to me of when we had the grand opening here. He said he was nervous in front of everybody.
That's a hard instrument. これは、まあ、私も同じものを持ってるんですが、これ竹でできておりますこれ長さ18センチそして内径が一番細いところで、まあ約1センチぐらいで、これ桜の木の皮をずっと巻いて上からブルシを塗っているものなんですでここのこの
So this is called hichi. It's 18 centimeters in length and 1 centimeter in diameter at the small point. And it's made out of bamboo and it's got the cherry wood that's wrapped around it and then they put the varnish on it on top of
that. そして、それを円形のものを熱を加えながらこうずっと潰していって、このような形、片っぽだけぺちゃんこのような形にして。で、これを、このダブルリードといたしましては、これが世界最大級のリードの大きさに。他のものは、2つのパンと割って、それをくっつけて、まさっとする。
So this reed comes from a plant or it's literally a reed called ashi, and it's a plant that is round, and what they do is with heat they flatten that out on one end. And it's the world's largest reed. Like if you have the oboe and the other instruments, the wind instruments, they have much smaller reeds. And how they make those is they have two pieces that they bring together and wrap up. But this is actually one plant or the reed that's been flattened out. So this is a reed of Oichi Sensei's reed, and it's a, they've now created a deeper relationship with people like that.
それが私は今回カナダで皆さんに縁をいただいて来させていただいた
それが少しでも痛かったのかなという思いもありますし、それがちょっとでも皆さんが興味を持っていただければ、私もこちらの方に伺った甲斐があったかなと思います。ぜひともですね、この会教室の先生方もいらっしゃることです。一緒にお勤めをするというですね、心を合わせるということを大切にしていただければなというふうに思います。本当に、ありがとうございました。
So I'd like to express my gratitude to all of you for providing me with this opportunity to come here and share with you a little bit about the rituals and the chanting. And it, his wish is that even if just a little bit it piqued your interest or you have a little more appreciation towards the rituals and chanting, then he feels that he's accomplished his role here, and he hopes that going forward, we have the ministers here in Canada, that you will join them in the chanting and the rituals, and he's again expresses his true appreciation for having providing him with this opportunity to come here and share with you. So thank you. Thank you for that.
Grant, the LDC director, say a few words.
So as LDC director, I want to again thank everybody on behalf of the JSBTC and the LDC Living Dharma Center. We want to thank everybody for attending and taking part in this wonderful opportunity to deepen our appreciation with Izui Sensei. So we thank Hongwanji as well for sending you and for coming back to visit us again. And thank you again to Reverend Grant for your translation, because not many of us have the facility anymore to understand the Japanese, so thank you again for your hard work as well. Thank you, Reverend Yoshi, for allowing me to use your read. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Last October, I was in Japan with the JSBTC. We had a tour, and I was in Nara with my cousin at the museum there, and all of a sudden I get a phone call. Who's calling me here now? And I answered, and it was Izui Sensei. So I want you to come to the office of the rituals department. I'm going, oh no, what did I do now? his supervisor, Reverend Sugiura, has also come to Canada before. He said, it's been a while since we've been to Canada to do anything on rituals. And he said, why didn't you set something up? So I came back and I called Soja. I said, we should do something. And that's how this came up.
Oh,
so,
nice.
Thanks to
Izui. Nice.
I had no idea how he contacted me.
So
thank you all for coming. So if we can gather at the family.